What are some of the printing differences between no-clean and water-soluble solder pastes?
Interesting question, because you may not think that there may be a difference between the two.
Right.
But actually, the water-solubles don't print as well as the no-cleans. All the testing that we've done across the particle sizes, type 3, 4, 5, and 6, we find that the no-cleans print better than the water-solubles. And some of the thought behind that is that perhaps the rosin, which is basically tree sap, does a very good job at stencil roll once it fills the aperture, and then maintaining that shape once it's printed into the aperture. The rosin does a very good job in doing that.
Ed, what are some of the reflow differences between no-clean and water-soluble solder paste?
A lot of people think that the water-soluble chemistries are a lot more active and therefore give a lot better results in a reflow profile.
Right.
And that's not necessarily always the case. They're very active on the front end, yes.
Right.
And they're very good at removing existing surface oxide. But as you get further down the process in the reflow profile, they don't do a very good job in the oxidation barrier. So as things begin to reoxidize, the no-cleans, the rosins that you find in them are excellent oxidation barriers and therefore do a much better job, especially on the really small apertures that are very sensitive to the oven environment.
Very interesting topic, Ed. Where can we go for more information?
Visit us at indium.com or email me at ebriggs@indium.com.
Ed, fascinating as usual. Thank you.
Thank you.